Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. Updates for Windows are released all the time. If you want to keep your Windows 7 computer as secure as possible, it is important to install the latest updates. Updates from Microsoft include security, driver, and Windows updates. If you are running Microsoft software such as Microsoft Office, Windows Update can also provide updates for that software as well. The install of Windows updates can be automated. You can do this through the control panel, or if you are in an enterprise environment, you can install and control updates through a WSUS server. The WSUS server will allow you to download and deploy updates as well as create reports on which computers have been patched and which ones need to be patched. Windows updates fall into a number of different categories. The first of these is important updates. Important updates are updates that Microsoft considers essential. These include security updates. At the least, you should install important updates on your system. This will help to ensure that the system does not get compromised. The next category of updates is recommended updates. Recommended updates are not critical updates, but Microsoft recommended that they be installed, and thus the name recommended updates. These updates generally include definition updates for Windows Defender, minor bug fixes, and feature updates. The next category is optional updates. Optional updates generally include driver and language updates. Things like language updates are only required if you have a need for multiple languages on your computer. It is a good idea to update the drivers on your system to the latest version where possible. Updated drivers include bug fixes and feature updates. If your system is running fine, you may not need to update your drivers. Although rare, sometimes updating a driver can cause more problems than leaving the existing driver on your system, and thus, this is why driver updates are often considered optional. Windows 7 does include a driver rollback feature, so you can remove the driver if installing it causes problems. The last category is product updates. Product updates, of course, means Microsoft products updates. If you are running any Microsoft products, updates for these products may be available in Windows Update. Let's take a look at how to configure Windows Update on Windows 7. To configure Windows Update, open the Control Panel from the Start menu and select System and Security. From System and Security, select Windows Update. This screen will give you a summary of how Windows Update is running on your system. Currently, Windows Update is not configured. If I select the button Turn On Automatic Updates, this will switch on Windows Update with the default settings. On most systems, I would select this option. If you want to configure how Windows updates are installed, you can select the option Let Me Choose My Settings. From this screen, I can select how important updates will be installed. Windows updates are divided up into important, recommended, and optional. Important updates include security updates. If these updates are not installed, then your system may be vulnerable to a known exploit. At a bare minimum, you should install important updates. Recommended updates are updates that may be bug or driver fixes. Your system may run fine without them, but it is recommended that you install them. Lastly, there are optional updates which include language updates, games, and other add-ons that are not essential for your operating system to operate. For important updates, you have a number of different options. The first option will install updates automatically with no user interaction. This is recommended on most systems. The next option will download updates but let the user decide if they want to install them. Some updates may cause software conflicts with other software. If you have a system with specialized software, you may want to check what the update does before you install it. The next option, check for updates but let the user decide first if they want the update before it's downloaded, allows the user to decide which updates to download. The benefit of this option is that Windows will not download updates that you may not want. Large updates, like service packs, you may prefer to give to a user on a DVD rather than download it multiple times across the network. The last option effectively switches off Windows Update. Your system will not update itself unless you manually trigger an update. In this case, I will install updates automatically. Once selected, you also have the option to decide which days to install updates and the time. The default is every day at 3 a.m. If your computer is not on at this time, Windows will install the updates next time the computer starts up. Windows will add a delay before it starts installing updates. This prevents the computer becoming too sluggish when it first starts up in the morning and the user starts loading all their programs. The tick box, "Give me recommended updates the same way I receive important updates," will install recommended updates with the important updates. On most systems, I would tick this box to ensure recommended updates are installed automatically. Otherwise, you will need to install recommended updates manually. The next tick box gives a user without administrative rights the ability to install updates. Updates often require administrator rights to install. Ticking this option gives a general user without administrator rights the ability to install updates while at the same time not giving them any extra rights. Once you have selected your options, you will be taken back to the original Windows Update screen. Notice that it tells me how many important updates and optional updates are available. If I select Important Updates, I can view the list of updates and also decide which updates I want to install. Since I have enabled updates to install automatically every day, deselecting an update will only stop them being installed this time. To make sure an update never gets installed, right-click the update and select the option Hide Update. If I now select the option Optional, you can see the optional updates for the system. Normally, add-ons such as language packs and additional software appear in here, for example, Windows Live and additional games. Once I have decided on the updates I want to install, I can press OK and then select the option Install Updates. Sometimes you may get a prompt asking you to accept a license agreement before installing the updates. Windows updates will now be downloaded and installed on the computer system. If I select the option on the left-hand side that says View Update History, this will show me all the updates that have been installed on this system. You can see here that one update was installed and two were canceled. The computer was probably restarted before the update could be installed. If you have updates in here that are not installing correctly, you may need to do some investigation to find out what the problem is. If I go back to the summary screen, I can select the option Restore Hidden Updates. On this screen, I can re-enable updates that were previously disabled or hidden. That's it for Windows updates. Although easy to set up, they are essential to ensuring that your system is as secure as it can be. In the next video, I will look at how to manage hard disks in Windows 7. If you have enjoyed this free training video, please feel free to look at our YouTube channel or website for more free videos. Thanks for watching.